depends if you have ever taken antibiotics. Most of us have taken antibiotics at some point in our lives, and that is because antibiotics are good at what they do, which is killing bacteria. But unfortunately, they do not distinguish between bad bacteria and good bacteria. So when a person takes antibiotics, it kills off the majority of their healthy bacteria, opening the door for bad bacteria to grow. Did you know that when you take antibiotics, it increases your chances of getting C. difficile infections by up to 10 times? And C. difficile is a nasty bacteria that causes severe diarrhea that is difficult to treat and that could unfortunately lead to death. And the problem that we have with C. difficile infections is that the current treatments are inadequate. We rely heavily on the use of very strong antibiotics that a lot of bacteria are resistant to. But there is hope. With new treatment options, like the use of antibodies, C. difficile causes disease by producing toxins that directly damage the gut. And antibodies, which are naturally occurring proteins, are capable of binding to these toxins and neutralizing their effect. And although this treatment is effective, its clinical use is limited. And that is because it's very expensive to make and to store. My project aims to change that. So instead of using a whole antibody molecule, we have the technology that allows us to create fragments that are smaller in size, easier to produce, easy to store, and that work just as effectively. And right now, I'm actually testing these fragments in the lab to prove that they are capable of preventing cells from dying when they are exposed to C. difficile toxins. And then the next step that I'm going to be doing is to test these fragments in mice that are infected with C. difficile. And I believe that the fragments are going to help mice recover from these infections, even though usually these infections are deadly to them. The ultimate goal of my project is to provide hope for C. difficile patients where they can have effective treatments that are accessible and cheap, and also to provide in the future for all of us the ability to take antibiotics without having to worry about getting subsequent C. difficile infections. Thank you.